Good evening.
I'm Neil.
And I'm Mike.
And we're playing Minecraft.
Yeah, well, at least as a holdover and a Skylands.
And I think you spelled Skylands wrong.
Yep.
You put an L in there.
Well, that's Skylands.
You spelled it S-K-L-Y.
Oh.
A-N-D-S.
I wasn't looking at the screen.
That's fine.
Well, at least as a way to say, we haven't done a video in a long time.
That's true.
And we both don't know that much about this game.
Well, you know a lot more than I do. I probably clocked in about 5 hours, and then I decided that it was just too much of my free time. So I stopped playing. It was like one day.
Well, I figure this game's pretty easy going. We can at least pick it up and talk and get some, at least some sort of video out there for people that are waiting, because I've tried a few other games and none of them worked out quite yet. So before we choose another game we're going to play, we can do this because it's very simple to
Yeah, we can pick up and play this too. Yeah.
This world is not very good.
No, it's not.
But
it's a lot of snow. I've been used to the Xbox 360 Minecraft, which is kind of different.
Yeah, your dad plays that.
My dad actually, he quit playing that. I think I don't know what he does now, but he quit Morrowind or whatever that game is, Skyrim. He quit this, and now he's just, I don't know, watches movies.
But yeah, so anyways, we haven't done any videos in a while. Well, I thought that's not very good at this. The funny thing is, people are like so good at this game now.
Yeah, we're
that like people will just watch this and be like, wow, what is wrong with them?
So we made a crafting table.
You don't need to explain this.
Okay.
I promise.
I like to remind myself.
Yeah.
So that I know what we're doing. I just got back from a road trip.
Can I? We
have stuff to talk about.
Definitely. I like enemies. You know? I'm not a baby.
That's true.
Also, let me put up. You can talk.
Oh, so.
There we go. I need to be able to see.
Okay. Well, I recently went on a road trip, and I haven't told you about that.
Not really, not much.
No.
I've got little details, but
got
back.
A 10-hour trip to Washington, D.C.
Yeah.
From there, 10 hours to Nashville. From there, 3.5 hours to Dayton, Tennessee. And then a 19-hour drive back to Boston.
Okay.
A lot. I never want to get in a car again.
Yeah, because then your butt will hurt.
Yeah. A lot of butt hurt. Actually, today, I've been...
On a scale of 1 to 10, how much did your butt hurt on the first hour?
In the first hour? It was probably, like a 1 or 2, but by hour,
No pun intended.
8. I was probably up to 5 on the butt hurt meter.
All right.
It was more a discomfort than a pain, actually. So it was pretty fun. I don't know.
Yeah.
Tennessee's really cool. Nashville's has a really cool music scene. I hate the music. I'm just not into country music. Ooh, that is a cool sword. Kind of weird. The South is a lot different from the North.
Yeah, yeah. We're from the Northeast. Yeah. We're from the good old liberal state of Massachusetts.
Yeah, because I do remember, I think I texted you a few things that might have been kind of could be taken as negative, like bashing the South. I won't get into that.
We're not here for love. We're not here to bash.
I will say very hospitable.
Yes.
Yeah, so very hospitable to people, and they have a very interesting way of speaking that is quite different from the way that we speak.
Wow. That's
to be nice.
Spot on.
Also something kind of noteworthy is when I went down there, the house we were staying at was a bunch of people that were in the Nashville music scene.
Yep.
And one of the guys that lives at the house is actually a Nashville, a country music singer, and he has a song on the Billboard charts, the actual Billboard charts, and not just the country music Billboard.
And his name is?
Chase Rice. He had something to do with the song Cruise by the Florida Georgia Line. I'm pretty sure he's the lead singer, but I'm not exactly sure. He's a nice guy, though. Seems really tired because he just got back from the road, being on the road.
Okay, so he's
a little bit Jack Kerouac in that sense, because he's always on the road. That was interesting. DC is also cool. I took my friend Tom, who I was traveling with, whom you know, Took a few good pictures of him. I don't know if you saw them on the Facebook, but
I didn't.
One of them was I got a low angle shot of him in front of the Washington Monument.
All I saw was you guys at like the Oval Office thing.
Yeah, that was a fake Oval Office. Well, that was good though. Yeah, that was a good picture. Anyway,
I assumed you did not just
we waltzed in.
Waltzed in. Not yeah. Three of you or whatever, not American.
Yeah.
Hey, can we just
yeah. So
what am I doing right now? I need to find
what is your goal?
My goal right now is to find some
we need to find a place to live.
Like a open like a flat meadow type area. Also, I need some stone. This is
that's true.
Oh, there we go.
Okay, we got some stone.
No, so we got meadow.
I took a good picture of him in front of the Washington Monument
place to live.
From a low angle. As if the Washington Monument is his, like, his penis coming out of it.
Oh, right.
I don't know if you saw that. That was pretty good.
No, I haven't seen
and
that.
And then from the Jefferson Memorial, I got a picture of him and another one of my friends. What do you call it? Doing the...
Planking on the Washington Memorial?
No, not planking. Something better than planking. It's Eiffel Towering the Washington Monument, which I thought was kind of funny. In a weird way.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah. So yeah, that's kind of, I mean, plus, you know, work and you had camp all summer and
yeah, that was kept keeping me very busy.
Again. Yeah.
You have a story to tell me that you wouldn't tell me before.
Well, I just had a funny
like an anecdote.
Story, sort of, in a way.
Okay.
So in class, right?
Yes.
We had an assignment to this is creative writing.
Okay.
So it's like...
Well, you're a creative writer, so that makes sense.
It's like a hodgepodge, not serious, kind of waste of time class.
Yeah. Well, these are people that are taking creative writing so that instead of doing homework, they can...
Well, I mean, it is like you have to have like English 102. You can't just walk in.
Yeah. Okay, fair enough.
It's got like something. But... no, that's my other class. It's just... what people take to waste their time. But anyways.
Which class is that?
Children's literature.
Oh.
Which I took because I needed a credit.
That sounds fun because then you can make a children's book.
Also, I want to write a children's book. So, I mean, it fits anyways.
It's kind of a win-win.
Ooh, what is that? I'm trying to find, I need to make a furnace pretty fast.
Yeah.
So, but anyways, I have...
Are you hungry too? You have like a hungry meter.
Yep.
That's not on the Xbox One.
No, the Xbox One is old.
Yeah.
Hunger meter kind of sucks sometimes. Because you start losing life if you don't eat. But, anyways. So, we had this assignment, right?
Yeah.
We had to write 3 sentences. One of them...
Fair enough.
One of them had to be a lie. No, 2 of them had to be lies and 1 had to be truth.
Okay, I've done that before. It's like a team building.
Yeah, and we had to go into a team.
Yeah.
Talk about these, right? And then, I'll just throw this on the fireplace. Oh, it has to be real wood. I forgot about that.
We gotta go fetch some real wood then.
So
one of them had to be a truth. So two lies and a truth.
Two lies and a truth. And so we get to groups. It's me, this kind of slackery kid, and these 2 girls. One of them's kind of cute.
That's good.
One of them's more mom-like.
I don't know. Moms can be all right.
Like, might be 30.
Okay.
Like, not...
Oh, like, she's going back to school.
Not
or, like, never
old.
Got a chance to.
She did go back, from what I gathered later.
Okay.
But, anyways, she had already graduated, but she, for some reason, wanted to take more classes.
So she's an overachiever.
Yeah. So, So mine were, I guess I'll start by having you see if you can tell.
Okay.
Sentence 1. When I was at Disney World, I was on Space Mountain when it broke down. And feel free to question me after.
Okay.
Number two. I don't think you've heard the story of any of these, so like you wouldn't know, hopefully. When I was at Disney World, I saw an alligator in the parking lot and I threw rocks at it. Or when I was at Disney World, I ate really bad food and threw up in the middle of the park. Those are my three. I'm not a good liar either.
See, I was going to call you out on the first two because I thought that you never went to Disney World. So it's completely news to me.
No, no. But, like, I just do not hold up to scrutiny. This is my problem. I can come up with them.
Yeah.
They weren't even good. I was just, the whole assignment just sucked. And then, like, I just feel bad lying to people. So even if it's the stupidest thing.
Was it the vomit one that's true?
I'll tell you, the first one's a lie on the ride. And the first question I got asked, the kid was like, how long was the ride broke down? And I immediately felt so bad that I was lying to him. I was like, 10 minutes. I'm so sorry. He just like looked at me. I was like, this is, and I was like, I'm lying.
You'd be a really bad politician then.
I know. And
because you'd be like, we're going to get 20,000 jobs next year. And they're like, really? And
you're like, I'm like, no, fuck no. I can't do that. No.
I'm sorry. I can't do it.
That's really hard.
Maybe 10. And they won't even be good jobs. They'll be sanitation jobs. I'm sorry.
All right. We got to build this bed stat because night's coming.
Okay. Did you have wool? Did you get wool?
Yep. I got what I need. I got what I need to hopefully.
You got what you need.
But anyways, so this other girls are like, let's say her first one is, I grew up on Martha's Vineyard and I can't swim.
I believe it.
Okay, that was one.
Okay.
Second was, I like to fish. Which, right there, I already
call bullshit on that one.
No, already though, I was like, really? That's your fucking lie?
Yeah.
Like, what is it? Like, I like to fish, I like Slurpees, and I like to climb trees.
I hate that.
It's like, that's, you like, you at least have some sort of imagination to these fucking things.
Yeah, yeah,
like,
yeah. I like your throw rocks at the
LA. That was true.
That's the truth one.
But anyway,
that's
the one I wanted to be true right now.
Okay, that's
what
the
I'm gonna
that
say
I really
is,
wanted to be true.
So she goes, so it comes down to it, and like she, I'm like, well, how long have you lived on the vineyard? And she's like, 10 years or something. And I'm like, oh, and you've never went swimming and whatever.
You know,
and it came
why
down to the voting. Yeah. And right, and I voted wrong. Turns out she likes to fish.
Really?
And she can swim, I guess, or something.
I would have called bullshit on that. I would have. It would have made sense.
She had
to
a
me
fucking fish on her shirt, and when she said I can't swim, I in my head I went, "Yeah, right. You have a fish on your shirt." But I didn't say that when she said I like to fish. I didn't go, "Obviously, you have a fish on your shirt."
Yeah, because if you have a fish on a shirt, it means that you are a fish and that you can
right
swim.
Yeah, so that's like it's the worst logic I've ever had. But and the girl, the other girl, the stupid girl, she goes like this. Oh, which ocean do you fish at?
Maybe that's a valid question.
I'm just like,
that's a weird question though. Like, which? Oh, the Atlantic Ocean.
The Atlantic?
Yeah. What ocean? There's only a few choices.
I didn't know what to do.
I think she meant what beach? Maybe.
That I hope she meant what beach, but I kind of felt bad for humanity at that point. But yeah, I'm going to bed. But no, it was just,
that's too much.
Too much for me. Like. Anyways, yeah, I threw rocks at an alligator.
That is, why have you never mentioned that to me?
Because I didn't think you were ready to handle it.
Okay, because that's cool.
Are you ready?
That's almost like attacking a dinosaur.
It's when I went to Disney World, and I met a kid from New York, and he taught me how to cheat at the arcade.
Really? How did you cheat? How did you?
You would hold it at a very specific angle and put coins in it.
Yeah.
In the machine, and every time it would roll down and hit the 50. And I had like 10,000 tickets by the time I left, and I got like 13,000 green army men.
Oh my god, that's so cool.
And then we saw an alligator, and we threw rocks at it. I don't know why we were in the parking lot alone.
Friends for
we were
life.
Like 8 years old.
Yeah, it doesn't sound like you should have been in that situation.
Alright, I'm gonna,
Was the alligator pissed?
Was the alligator pissed?
Yeah.
Is that a thing?
Like, was
I'm
he
alligator pissed.
No, was he angry? Like, was the alligator pissed off that you were throwing rocks at it?
So you're saying, like, were you alligator pissed?
Were you alligator
pissed? I'm not alligator pissed.
No. I don't even know what that is.
Was he pissed? I don't know. I'm alive.
Oh, my God. Are you done with that story?
Yeah.
I have another. Okay. So I went, when I was in Nashville, went to a bar. There's a band playing at this bar. And the guy was fucking sang the best song ever. It's what so good.
That?
Okay. He was like, all right, this next one, I'm going to need...
How did I get a snowball, anyways?
I don't know. I think because there's snow on the ground. Yeah. So the guy was up there. It was like some like rock country band. And he was like, I'm going to need some audience participation for this thing.
Yeah.
He didn't say it like that because he was Southern, but like, you know, you can imagine. So he goes, All right, this next song is called Red, White, and Blue. When I say red, you say neck. When I say when I say white, you say trash. When I say
blue, I thought he was gonna say when you say white, I say blue. I'm just gonna die.
And when I say blue, you say collar. Oh, and I was like, this is too much. And he's like, red neck, white trash, blue collar. And that was the chorus. And I was like, this is way too much for me.
I wish you had an iPhone.
I know. I looked it up online. I can't find it. If anyone can find it, please make it known, because I love that song.
Is it a real song?
I have no idea. I think it was just some guy at, if anyone's curious, played at the bar Losers during the Whiskey Jam. If that means anything to anyone.
Anyone in Nashville,
out there visiting or what, that song is too much. That's too good.
It's a banger.
It's so good.
But yeah, other than that, ending of Cave Story pending.
Oh yeah,
haven't decided.
I think you should post it.
We haven't recorded like except it's for the done. End because we couldn't beat it. But anyways,
well, no, that's like a secret. It is done.
It's not a secret if we never put it up.
Yeah, that's true.
I know people want to see the end.
Yeah,
but I didn't have any fun. I just have no faith that it's good.
It might be okay.
The problem is that you have to think a lot during this game. What? That game. So it was a bad choice because
this one's good because it's just kind of like going through the motions for most of it. Right. You're gonna build a great house.
I am gonna build a great house. Thank you. Well, I have a pond in my backyard.
Well, funny story. We were playing this game at my house. I'm trying to play it, like trying to like navigate my way through the game, and you were so frustrated that you just took the controller away from me and played it for 4 hours. And you're like, "Oh, this is your house now." And I was like, "I don't know how to make a house." It's like the dad that builds the like.
Because I felt like I was watching a child try to win the Special Olympics, and like it was a mixture of like sadness, but also like. Heartwarming.
Well, it was like I was trying to build my little like Kentucky Derby, like I don't know what that is, like the little derby car, you know, boy, like the Cub Scout thing. And I was like
you were banging on a piece of wood. Yeah,
I nailed this nail into this car. What do you think I can use that for? And then you're just like, oh my god. And then you're like, let me get my sander out. And you like build me, and it was fun though, because I was like, I feel like I did something, even though I was just there watching you do it.
Right, I'm gonna excavate the floor.
Okay.
And then we'll call this one.
Okay.
Today.
Can you get rugs in this game?
You can get wool, and you can dye the wool.
And make rugs.
I think we can do that. Actually. That sounds fun. We're gonna try to do that.
This is gonna be a problem.
We're gonna have to kill a lot of sheep, but that's fine.
Nah, I'm fine with that.
Because I think you get dye from flowers, which are right around the area.
Yeah.
So we can try and do that. I mean, what are your life goals in this Minecraft house?
I want stairs that go up to a second story. I want a widow's walk, first of all. So
like an step outside that goes up?
That's so if our husband ever comes back, we'll be the first ones to see it.
Right, right.
And then
like a flag go down.
Like a mine that goes down.
A mine?
Yeah.
No, you don't like the house mines. Remember what happened last time?
Oh, yep. Yeah, not good. Yeah, mine outside the house.
Yeah.
Maybe an outhouse for the restroom. Is there a restroom feature in this? We need to eat.
Oh, by the way. Shit. We need to eat. Do we have pork? No, we don't. We'll have to figure that out next time.
Oh, my God.
Anyways, I have to get out of this hole.
There we go.
Let's just kill this pig so that we can have food next time. Also, pork chop stack in this version.
Oh, nice.
It's so dumb in the other one when they don't.
I love stacking pork chops. Oh, I have a, never mind. I have an anecdote, but I'll save it for the next time.
Okay, I just put it down here.
This is good.
All right, well.
I love the furnace in this game, I don't know. It's just
cozy
different.
Up next to it, and next time, join us as we talk about space.